have to move fast. The water is rising. We have to save our precious things. Bring it to the attic before it's too late. Sandbags.
We need more sandbags or everything will be lost. What would you save if you only had 5 minutes before the floods of the river came into your living room? I was in that situation. In 1996, when this dike almost broke and could have put the whole region underwater. I lived between the rivers, and I grew up with a view of a coal-fired power plant on the one side and a nuclear power plant on the other. So maybe it's not so strange that I'm fascinated by water and energy. But something's going wrong with those elements that inspire me. Heat levels rising in cities, combined with sewage outlets into rivers, lead to oxygen deficiency. And this is what happens. Fish mortality, which leads to botulism. Global warming heats up our rivers and lakes. Agriculture and industry discharge large amounts of nutrients in our waters. And this is what happens. Excessive growth of algae infest our shores. Not only our recreation areas experience water quality problems, also closer to home, the effect of climate change and our dealings with nature are clearly visible. Our city canals heat up in summer and provide fertile ground for toxic bacteria. In addition to water quality issues, water safety is an ever-present challenge. Climate change by the use of fossil fuels provide longer periods of drought and more rainfall in short periods of time. This increases the peak flows in rivers dramatically. And this is what happens. Our traditional way of water management will soon prove insufficient to keep our precious property safe. The Netherlands has the best protected delta of the world. And we're very proud of that. And we will adapt to this new reality. But this comes with a price. Every day, thousands of surface water pumping stations pump billions of liters of water to keep our country safe. This takes a lot of energy. Energy that's still primarily generated by fossil fuels. The consumption of coal for electricity and diesel fuels to power our water management contribute to climate change. In response, we will have to adapt our water management systems to higher sea levels, peak flows, and longer periods of insufficient fresh water supply. But what if we could generate clean, renewable energy in a struggle against the water? Not fight the elements, but work with nature and make clever use of the resources that are all around us. We found a solution for this by making clever use of existing technology. And this is how it works. Why don't we extract heat in summer while pumping water for fresh water supply and store this heating energy in an aquifer thermal energy storage system? Okay, I will explain. The principle is quite simple. In summer, our surface water heats up to about 20 degrees. Here we can extract heat by a heat exchanger and store this heat energy on the ground, in a groundwater well, just as you can store warm water in a thermos bottle. In the winter, this warm water can be pumped up and converted into high-value heat for heating our homes. Our water management continues throughout the year. So in the winter, if we're not ice skating, we pump cold water to prevent flooding. Here we can extract cold, just as we can extract heat. This cold can be stored on the ground and provide highly sustainable cooling in our data centers and hospitals in wintertime. So in summer, we can extract heat and store it for the winter. And in the winter, we can extract cooling energy for the summer. This picture shows the red hotspots of the Delfland waterborne region in summertime. This is an area of about 400 square kilometers, which includes the cities of Rotterdam, The Hague, which you can clearly recognize by the high surface temperatures. Extracting heat from surface water will cool down the surface water. This has many effects, many positive effects. Cooling down the surface water makes that it can contain more oxygen. More oxygen prevents fish from dying and limits the risk of botulism and limits the spread of algae. Cooler surface water can even cool down our overheated cities in the summer. So by heating our home, we directly improve our environment. Not only can we gain renewable heating and cooling from our water management, we can also utilize our renewable energy better by pumping in an intelligent way. If you make use of forecasting and monitor water levels, water pumping stations can be powered by cheap renewable energy. Just like old times, pump only if the wind blows. To make this more concrete, what is the potential of a surface water pumping station as an energy factory? An energy factory, that has a positive sound to it. A factory where you can actually create energy with energy and can store it. This picture shows the Parksluizen pumping station in the center of Rotterdam. This could provide enough cooling energy for 5 hospitals. This picture shows also the Parksluizen station and also all the other almost 100 major pumping stations of the Delftland Waterboard region. You can imagine the energy potential of all those stations combined. Whole cities could be connected and provide heating, cooling, flood protection, and good water quality. Not only our cities could benefit. The Netherlands is a delta, which is the end of a major river where it branches out, just like many deltas out around the world, such as the Mississippi, the Yangtze River, and the Thames. And as we've seen recently in the UK, all prone for flooding. Hundreds of millions of people live in cities in these deltas. The smart pole could protect those deltas with Dutch water management systems and deliver renewable energy to the inhabitants of these cities, like New Orleans or London. So by cooling the hospital, of this lady, this won't happen. Or by heating the home of this man, these fish could live and providing healthy food and income. So what we created, is a climate-proof water management system that isn't a pollution source anymore, that helps reduce CO2 emissions and provide viable cities and clean water. This is the smart polder. We can start tomorrow. The technical solutions are there, and there's a very interesting business case. But to make this a success, we need to work together. Water authorities, you manage a tremendous source of renewable energy. Let us make use of this, and let us bring our water management system to the next level. We cannot save all the photo albums. We cannot save all the cities in the world from flooding. Climate change is here. But what we can do is make the deltas of the world safer and healthier with smart polder technology. Thank you.